Hey, buddy, so Victor has continued streak here. The Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but it is pretty standard for Saturday. However, the previous one did on Friday. Thank you all very much. That one actually crossed over 5,500 likes, making a huge push towards the end of yesterday. So thank you all very much. You went and checked out that run. It was a lot of fun. Yesterday's run was a lot of fun as well. If you haven't seen it yet, that one yet, definitely go check it out. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Boomer Baguettes. How the thread was, gotta love them farts. Me, watch us Invicta to fall asleep. Invicta. yeah, maybe that's, might be the new Jam Jar Boy. Boomer Baguettes, possibly. Thank you very much, all 229 of y'all that upvoted that one. Let's hop on in. Made sure that the mods are not running, because that would be very bad. See, today's going to be Delta 8, Zulu Tango, X-Ray Sierra, Delta, Delta, and we have ourselves an R key start, along with options as well. Oh my goodness. Kind of bad stats as far as our damage or DPS is concerned. Good range. Slow shot speed, not really fantastic. Damage to really talk about. Tears rate is kind of meh. But an R key start here is quite interesting. Quite interesting for a couple of reasons. Number one is that obviously we can go for an Omega run if we really, really wanted to. Off course, you can also get a lot of extra items on a run with the R key if you use it towards the end of a run, sort of thing. So, you know, is it worth keeping? I mean, I guess that's going to be the proverbial question for this run, is that if you start with R key, what do you do with it? You know, do you want to use it early and get like an extra early double deal, or do you just want to take advantage, just go whole hog and just start from scratch after you're done with the final boss of a run? I mean, it's a tough position to really think about. We never had an R key start before, so yeah, it'd be interesting. Thank you again, those of you who've been coming out to the Isaac Madness week. We've had a lot of people come over from the YouTube mosh pit to say hello. And we've had some interesting runs as well, some pretty crazy ones, I will say. Some that actually just broke the game straight up. Have you ever seen a run go into negative damage? Because we had. We had one run that had every shot reduces my damage by 0.1. So, and that was with kidney stones. As you can imagine, we were doing an entire run with basically no damage. And when I say no damage, I mean negative damage. Hangman card, we can go get that bomb that's in that room and then get that... tinted rock. And, or we could go to the secret room. Secret room is guaranteed to be right there. Honestly, I'd rather have the tinted rock for now. So we have a second soul heart there. Reason why we're not picking it up, of course, is because we do not want to accidentally lose it before getting to the double deal on the next floor. But yeah, that's the million-dollar question, is what are we going to do? Hold Jacob and Issa. Oh, I turned off the, I forgot to re-download the external information mod. Anyway, that's the soul of Jacob and Esau. What are we going to do with this R key? The R key provides you with a lot of opportunity. It opens up a lot of avenues in terms of, you know, you've got, you almost have unlimited potential with having a second run go off while being able to keep the first run's items, you know. And where that cutoff is going to be, it really just comes down to just how, it almost comes down to how long do you want your run to be. You know, we'll see. We'll see how well this one goes. I mean, I don't foresee myself holding it all the way to the end, especially if we end up like just not getting any stats. But if we end up balling out of control early, you know, could be getting a little, maybe a little Omega runish, maybe. You know, on by the way, the Omega run is killing all bosses in Repentance, all of them, including boss rush, including the optional bosses, all of them. And, you know, that is a very difficult thing to do. It took us a long time. We did two attempts in 1 week, and it so happened to work out that we did get the Omega run done. But if you haven't seen that one, go watch it. It is a huge, huge accomplishment. that was very hard to get, but there's lots of twists and turns. I think someone summarized it best. Someone said Sinvicta : the movie. That should be the alternate title for that episode. As you can see here, we're starting out with more options, which is going to give us two items that we can choose from. I'm wondering if we should go in the cursed room here. Will the soul of Jacob and Esau, will that grab the item for me? Gonna risk it. We'll go in. Okay. So, where did we get 5 bombs from all of a sudden? Was that from the... Oh, you know why? Okay, so that totally would have grabbed it. Because Esau started with Mr. Mega. So, and that's what gave us those 5 bombs. We're gonna do this game where we're just gonna get 2 cents per bomb. I'm gonna buy Diplopia. I'm not going to use it on Arky. I'm going to use it on our boss drop just to take both of them. And actually, I think we get 3 items here. So I will take the HP. Okay, we only get 2. That's fine. Golden pill.
Gulp.
Okay, well, we only used it twice. So we got the gulp, which is going to give us a... It turns Cricket's leg into a passive item. That's going to help out with our passive fly generation. And we're going to head on down. It's the golden Cricket leg, too, by the way. So we're going to get 2 flies instead of 1. This is a weird start, but could potentially ball out of control. That's the only worry right there is with the golden Cricket leg is spawning the explosive war flies. Not going to use a bomb for that. Potentially could be a huge waste of time. We get the black tooth, which is going to give us a sort of a tough love-esque type shot. There we go. If it ever hits. Hoping we get a tears up here. Damage up would also be nice. Right now, I'm skewing more towards we get to like Caves 2, maybe a little bit further than that to determine whether or not it is worth going for a not the Omega run necessarily, but getting a good run. We need to get something impactful here. I can take a little Loki. Because what we need, where we find ourselves in the position right now is that we have a plethora of opportunities that we don't want to squander. We don't want to back out of this run too early because we may get something incredible in the devil deal, or maybe one floor or two down the road. But I foresee us going for, let's say we go for angel deals on this run, and then if it doesn't work out, then we can just make the pivot over to devil deals on the Arky run. It just comes down to just how far do we want to let it go down. Like if we get to womb 1 and we still got nothing, then we gotta pull the plug. But if we're just destroying the game at a certain level, then we'll preserve it, and then we'll see how far we can really make this run tick. Saw the warfly there actually helping us out greatly, destroying a lot of those yellow spiders. A little bit of a hesitation there. I wasn't sure what that other spider on the right was going to do. The golden cricket, by the way, is causing these flies to spawn every time we kill something, or at least has a chance to anyway. I mean, remember, every time because it's a golden variant of the trinket, it's going to have the double effect. basically has twice the amount of activation potential. So the all important question now is, do we go for angel deals or do we go for devil deals? I think if we go for angel deals, that gives us more opportunity to grow. Because we're not, as soon as we go for devil deals, I don't remember if you take devil deals on run number one, R key, does it lock you into devil deals on the next run? I do not remember. I think we ran into this discussion on the Omega run as well, I believe, but I don't remember what the general consensus was. Let's see what Little Horn gives us here, and then we'll decide on what we're going to do. Right now, we need to get tears or damage, or both, preferably both. We have a good opportunity to do so because of more options. We're guaranteed to get a second boss item for this entire run, which is a phenomenal way to start. Way more customization options, way more problem-solving options that you can do. Unless, of course, you get old bandage and mom's underwear. This is looking a little doo-doo-ish. There was nothing in the store that we could go for. I'm gonna begrudgingly go for angel deals with the hopes that they bail us out here. No, we're not like hitting the panic button yet or anything. It's way too early to be doing that. We're only on floor three right now. But I worry about where this run is starting to kind of trend towards. Getting a little Loki in the item room was kind of a little bit disappointing. Another HP upgrade here from the boss. You know, old bandage is good if you're going for a red heart build, which we kind of have right now. But now the only reason why we're kind of like in this limbo uneasy state is because we don't know if we're going to get an angel deal. Obviously, we have a 34% chance. Of course, the way the angel deals have been going lately, we know that we have not been getting them on a regular, which has been a huge problem in these runs. But even in yesterday's run, even when going for the devil deal, we got two or three devil deals for the entire run. I mean, that's pretty bad. Sharp Key apparently has a whole bunch of fans out there, so shout out to Sharp Key fans. I didn't think it was all that cracked up. It was. Hey, there we go. Good shot. So if we miss the angel deal here, which is likely, then we look at the possibility of getting to Catacombs 2 or even Depths 1 without getting any special room. And I think where we pull the plug on the first run is if that happens. We use the R key and then start from scratch, hopefully with a better run. But we're not there yet. We might get some huge help here on this floor. Never know. That's the thing about Isaac is that you just never know. You'll never see the same run, the same room being played the way it is. I mean, you on the same combination of seeds, like it's just impossible. Actually, really surprised that this blue champion is still alive after getting hit by a poison tooth and being poisoned for the entire duration. There we go. All right. Virgo gives us a damage shield and also makes all pills turn into neutral positive effects. So that could have some impact on this run if we get enough pills. Another golden pill would be fine now. Honestly, I didn't think that leech was going to break that fast. So that is a double charge battery, which we obviously don't have a space bar item to use that with right now. And we're not going to get rid of our key for nothing.
Oh,
But you know, if we're starting off the next run with these with the same stats, you know it's just a bad run. Oh yeah, what am I doing? Yeah, I think we'll just go fight the boss. Gonna be frail. It is everything that we do not. Well, that we get a chance to get the angel deal here. The meteor is frail moving a lot faster than usual. I can't really use the bomb here on the outer shell. What is going on with these ricochets? I think frail is just bouncing off of like the dips. Okay. Yeah, this frail is moving way faster than usual. They never push the bomb like that. Getting some chip damage there with the fly orbital, which was doing a decent amount. Hey, there we go. We did get the angel deal. Growth hormones is devil. Or as damage, I should say. I mean, Jar of Wisps is kind of, you know, it's not gonna replace Arky. My only hesitation here is losing. I don't want to lose this Eternal Heart. So the movement speed up that we got, it was nice. The damage up that we got with growth hormones was even better. That's what I want you to do. I want you to jump in the fire there, Uriel. There you go. We don't want him stuck at the top like this. Yep. And that's why. I don't know why Uriel has just been the bane of my existence every time we find him. Every time we fight him. I never used to have problems reading his attacks, but it's the diagonal shots that he just gets me on every single time. We get a little horn, which is a good item. Now we can go in the curse. We can go in the curse room basically worry free. So disappointing angel deal there. Even though we got it, it's not going to. I mean, the only thing we got out of the angel deal was getting a higher chance to get an angel deal. That's about it. So, you get a pill here. There's perks, which gives us the wafer effect. It's funny. I thought you would think that the little horn science shot would destroy poops if it just does that. We can't go into the boss trap room because we're not at full HP. And yeah, just head on. We'll just head on down. Sorry about that. I do get up and answer the door. So hoping for some better things here on this angel deal. There goes the wisp. I mean, I don't know what I expected. I knew that the wisp wasn't going to live that much longer. There goes our angel deal, unfortunately. So yeah, we're starting to. If this were a graph, we're starting to trend downwards here pretty quickly. We really need a tiers upgrade at this point. 2.5 damages or 2.5 shots per second is, again, it's not the worst. It's just not optimal what we're looking for right now. If we had a little bit better shot speed, we'd be looking at a much different outlook on our DPS here. Our damage, while decent at 4.25, and certainly growth hormones was a huge help. is not barn burner right now. We're not looking at, I mean, the barn's burning, but it's not for the best reason. That thing's on fire right now. Still too early to call, of course. Getting a soul heart here will be nice. We'll come back and grab that before the boss. To hold on to a shred of hope that we can still somehow get an angel deal out of a 9%, basically 10%. I mean, it's 9%, but... And I don't know if bombing the... If we even find the shop, bombing the keeper would even be worth it. But we're not going to fight the boss yet because we want to go in the item room. The big time player of this run is going to end up being more options. The item that we started with. High Priestess kind of changed that. We can grab this. And this hopefully will be an insta dunk on the boss. Well, never mind. It's going to be Mega Fatty. That's half of his HP gone, but I'm hoping that we get some good luck here with Bighorn. Littlehorn and Bighorn can shred bosses if it procs. There we go. That's what we want. There we go. Again, we didn't expect it, but. Now, shot speed here is good. However, we would have 2 of 3 for spun. I normally wouldn't be doing this, but because we already have one syringe and we're only on caves 2, plus we have the R key, I think that going for experimental treatment is the only play here. And it took damage, but it did give us tears. But the damage down is a pretty big deal. We gained everything but damage and movement speed. So, you know, in the grand scheme of things, losing one damage, is that a big deal? Not if we're getting tiers, not if we're getting a tiers rate up, to compensate for that. You know, and we also got shot speed up too, which again was one of those things that we kind of needed. So it was probably an even trade there. We got HP, I think, as well. So we've certainly seen worse rolls on experimental treatment. But you're seeing the problem right now that we're currently running into is not being able to protect our HP. And some people are going to say, like, well, you should just dodge that shot, blah, blah, blah. No, that's not the point. The point is that if we had the damage high enough to land those shots that we were before the NASA worms moved, they would have died before that shot that actually hit us ever got off. That's the whole, and right there, that's the whole reason why I talk about this concept of damage protecting your HP. Now we're just on tilt right now. Okay, let's dial it back here because this is going to be one of those situations where it's just, I cannot believe that one hit us. We have the movement speed to deal with this. I'll check the curse room here for a soul heart or 2 or 10. Get one. We're going to end up leaving that with a half soul heart. No secret room to find. Super secret room might be here. And I think we just head on down. Yikes. So my thought process about this run is as follows. We need damage on this floor. And we cannot miss this angel deal. If we miss, if neither one of those things happens, we're hitting the R key. We're starting over. If we don't get damage and if we miss the angel deal, I will be forced to use the R key, because getting to depths 2 with this damage, even if we were at 4.25, is not conducive with a successful run. I think that that's the best use of R key in this present moment. So, you know, Arky giving us that ability to do so is huge. Don't get me wrong. I'm glad we got it. Because this would be absolutely brutal if we tried to take this into the late game and just, you know, we like this isn't a winning build right now. Cricket leg definitely helping us out. Love seeing these giant rooms here. The plays by Bighorn. The Warflies have been helping out a lot. I'm glad they're there. They've been helping us kind of keep down the numbers of the smaller enemies. This is where shot speed plays such a huge part in landing accurate shots. You might be shooting at the right angle, but if the shot doesn't get there in time, it doesn't matter if you shot at the right angle, because it's not going to land. We get Spider Mod here. I don't really want to take either of these. I mean, Spider Mod can at least deal damage sometimes. And freeze the enemies. The battery is a better play if we had a spacebar item. But at least with Spider Mod, I can see enemies that are in underground and, you know, ones that are trying to pull some schmooves on us. It's gonna be another one of them thinking episodes here. That's a dangerous thing. You don't want me thinking. That is not who I wanted to see up here. All right. Looking for our item rooms. Item room, I should say. Right now, all signs are definitely pointing to using our key on this floor. The only way I won't use R key on this floor if we miss the Angel Deal and we don't get a damage upgrade is I truly do not feel like being in this room. Screw everything about that room. The only way that I don't use R key is if we miss the Angel Deal is if we have enough soul hearts to get through the next floor to get our guaranteed deal. This is fun here. Yep. Yep. Yeah, we're hitting the R key on this floor. At this point, that I have to. This is a pretty dire situation that we're in. Losing that one damage on experimental treatment was actually a lot bigger of a deal than it seemed at the time. But there's now, I don't think, any scenario that I don't use R key here on this floor. Pretty flies, pretty good. And just looking for the right way to go here. Not found our item room yet, which means it's probably in the corner of this level. Oof, yeah, that is just... That is real bad. We got the jump on that bone hand. It didn't even put a dent in it. I mean, we almost killed it, but like that's the point. Like, we should have killed it. And looks like the old item room's over to the south here. Let's just go on and get on in there. I mean, the finger is extra damage. It's piercing damage. But the problem with the finger is, again, it comes down to control. It comes down to, can we control where our damage goes at all times? The answer is no, we can't. You start inside of a new room with a barrel right next to the door, or like a bomb fly or something like that. It's gonna get you hit. We're interested in one thing and one thing only right now, and that's damage. Just raw damage is what we're looking for. We got our angel deal. We have to go luck upgrade here for the little horn procs. Yeah, I think that is gonna do it for this here run. I am gonna get the key piece from Gabriel here, and then we are gonna hit it, because, well, I may wait until we get to the, let's at least go to the item room on the next floor, because obviously, like, we're not gonna get an extra boss item from Mom. This is Gabriel, like, just going in. He's just moving. I think what we do is we go to the next item room only, maybe check the shop, and then we're bouncing. We're out. We have one thing on the mind right now. That is, if we see the shop, cool. But we're going to the item room just to see if we can get something out of there. Getting a syringe would be great. Euthanasia would be acceptable. Adrenaline, anything that gives us spun. Spun will be a massive help to us. Luck up that's actually really, really good. Yeah, we're starting to trend upward in the luck department. Are these investing terms working for you? No, they're not. I've been playing too much Zed Run, man. Or maybe not enough. I'm honestly, like, I am all in with Zed Run. It is a very, very fun experience. My obsession for the last couple of days. Those of you who've been watching the Twitch stream will know all about it. Yeah, well, we found the store before the item room, which is, you know, pretty common. Dreamcatcher, it's half price. There's no real good reason to not take it. And it's gonna help us on the next run as well. Did Spider Mod Poison that gluttony, or was that an errant tooth shot? There's our fool card, which honestly isn't even worth the bomb. Now, I say that, but with us being here, if we do happen to get an angel deal, we're at a 33.8% right now. If we get an angel deal and we have the mystery gift, assuming that we don't lose the angel deal, that could be an option here for us. But it would also mean that I'd have to use our last and our final bomb on the fool card. But right now we are in desperation mode now. So we are banking on us passing this now 37 or 36.3% chance roll for the angel deal. If it doesn't, then we keep the mystery gift, use it in the secret room, and hope for something like Echo Chamber or a devil deal, not a devil deal item, a large HP item that we can use for devil deals, like raw liver, black lotus, that's something like that. She's just not gonna. You run out of feet, Mom? What's going on here? Bro, I'm not going near the door. So you can just, like, get that thought out of your head. I'm not going over there to kill you. Yeah, this is what a Mom fight with 3.25 damage looks like. We're getting almost 10 damage every time she drops her foot, Stonks on stonks on stonks. There's some damage. That was a great block by Pretty Fly. Holy moly. There's some good damage there from Cricket's leg. I say Cricket's leg, but a Cricket's leg, you know what I mean. That's what I get. I should have just gone up there and just shot that. Now, the absolute worst thing that we could do is lose this angel deal. Good damage there by, I think that was Orbital. Yeah, we got the cheeky little hit in there. Didn't quite work out. We didn't get the angel deal. We didn't expect the angel deal. So that was a very, very, very long fight. We have no bombs, so the secret room is not an option currently. And here's our item room. I think we just look for the cursed room. Let's just use it in the item room. We get what we get, and then we'll use our key and the. Okay, great. Alrighty. So, our key, now is your time. Apologies to everyone seeing the thumbnail thinking, oh man, our key, this is gonna be a good run, right? Yeah, buddy. All right. Delta 8, Zulu, Tango, X-Ray, Sierra, Delta, Delta. Did I even read off the seed at the beginning of this episode? I don't even know. That was like 40 minutes ago, man. All right. So, Arky. Now is the time where you show your value. We get a fresh start here. We did well for what we had. Which, let's be honest, wasn't a whole lot. But our key now being used lets us start over again. We just get a brand new run. The timer does not stop, of course, but we get to keep all the items that we had from the previous run. And, I'm going to go for the horse bill. Ears up would be awesome. Balls of steel. That's a new one. I haven't heard that one, Matthias. Horse pill, of course, going hand in hand with Virgo is great. Where is he? Oh, Spider-Mod shrank him over there. Okay. The Hagala's Rune and Death card. Leech, welcome out to the party. Good to see you. I apologize if I scoffed at your existence, like most of our item rooms here. Leech, there's nothing wrong with Leech. Especially with us having so many red hearts here. And now's our fresh start. And that's the main important thing about Arky, is that if you do have a dud of a run, you have a chance to get a second dud of a run. Hey, look at that. We're already ahead. All right, so it's going to be... Oh, never mind. I was going to say it's going to be Paws and Chubb, but it's Curse the Blind. So, yeah. And that is, of course, one of the worst scenarios to come out of that, because now we don't know what our angel, we don't know what our devil deals are going to be. We're not going angel deal again. Angel deal, y'all had your chance. Y'all definitely had your chance. Now it's time for like the real items to take over. Let's let Stanley do his magic and just go ham with hopefully offensive upgrade, you know, all that kind of stuff. Oh, it actually did give us pause. Okay. Pause is, pause ain't bad. If we get hit, we can use pause and then use the attack fly, which does a good amount of damage. You can also just let Leech just go ham. I don't think leeches would like ham. They would love pigs. I don't think they'd like ham. Or maybe they do. Maybe there's a leech expert out there. It's just like, oh my gosh, YouTubers don't know anything. That's true. I mean, YouTubers usually don't know anything. Hey, I'm a YouTuber. $0.27 here, and it's not Chubb, it's Larry Jr. what we're really hoping for is good damage here, like a pentagram or something off of Larry Jr. We get Wooden Spoon, it's movement speed. And we get 9 lives. I mean, look, there's nothing wrong with 9 lives. Hopefully it leads to Guppy. I had a little bit bigger hopes for all that HP that we had, because I was going to go play the arcade. Now, we do have a blind hook. Blind claw game, not hook. Unfortunately, we didn't... I mean, I guess it worked out because we don't even have a blood bank. I'm not even going to go in the store. It's Curse the Blind. We'll just head on down. That was Tech 1. And let me tell you something, brother. Tech 1 is the surefire best way for us to start turning this one around. We get a tears up. Get a luck up. I mean, this we're starting to feel it. Can you feel it, Mr. Krabs? We're about to start really, really taking off now. 4.25 damage, still has 3.25 damage, or 4.25 tiers, 3.25 damage, but Tech 1 is going to be huge for us. Really? I'm honestly not convinced. Okay, now I'm convinced. That's actually really surprising that the secret room is not there. It's in the perfect spot for it, too. This is free entry into this cursed room here because we have that soul heart that popped out from somewhere. I would have lost them. I would have lost the house on that bet. Get pride and wouldn't mind getting. No, honestly, I think that I do think that pause is still our best option here. If we take damage, we're going to be able to punish that really, really well with the attack fly orbital. There's marbles. Heck, whizzle. Let's go. Tech 1 is going to give us an unlimited range laser shot that scales just like any other tier does. But, man, oh, man, if you have a good tiers rate with Tech 1, you're happy. And you're seeing here the application rate because if one shot procs Littlehorn, that entire shot becomes a Littlehorn shot. And anything that gets caught in the crosshairs of Tech 1 all of a sudden gets hit with Littlehorn. So multiple targets, piercing. Hopefully we get something like spectral tears. We're gonna be sitting pretty. The Tech 1 definitely is a huge boon to this run. Hey, you just saw the double application there of Littlehorn. Well, that spider got by. Coupon, I mean, we might as well use it once, but sure. A coupon, we can take devil deals, of course, but we're not going to need that. So this is what I'm talking about. We get hit, you punish. Just like that. Another tears up. Yeah. Eye drops is going to max us out here. And we're going to head on down. I'm honestly still shocked that the secret room is not there. Super secret room might be over there. We only have one bomb. We don't need to go find the secret room. Hang on. Before we leave this floor, before we go do that, let's go get these two golden chests, because that could be our ticket to, I don't know. Wherever you want to go. name a place. We'll get another bomb here. We actually get a second bomb. You can get even more bombs. I'm going to take the matchstick over the counterfeit penny. We could play for marbles, but I'd rather buy two premium items out of the store instead of possibly wasting them against the claw machine. A super secret room, and we get a golden bomb. Okay, now we're ready to go. Good floor, really good floor. So we have Ares and Peep. Now, Ares is an item that many people keep saying that I need to take closer and closer looks at, because the charge up time for you to be able to damage and also I think be invincible with it. Get the Bible. It's going to save us some keys. We're also going to get 2020 out of here, which is going to be real nice. That'd be Bookworm Revelations. I'm not going to use that. Tank Bible. I will use that. Actually, you know what? I think going with the Satanic Bible is better here, just for guaranteed devil deal items. I think that's, with 9 lives and the amount of HP that we've got, I think that that's our best bet. Room's actually pretty hard to get out of without taking any damage. Now here's where we went wrong in the last run, which was losing that angel deal to this room. But again, you're seeing just what a difference makes when you've got damage. Even though our damage hasn't gone up, the stat up has not gone up, our ability to deal damage has gone up. And the amount of damage that we're doing per second is significantly higher than when we were last time we were here. And and we're able to, I mean, the proof is in the pudding. You see how much HP we've got. You know, we're able to effectively dispatch enemies out of any room at a very good rate. And on top of that, we have our range, our unlimited range, that we're also exploiting to our advantage because we don't have to get close to things now. So, you know, that's kind of like what I keep discussing and, you know, telling people, like, hey, look, you might have a lot of HP, but, you know, what is your ability? Is it because of your main ability to just play the game, or is it something else? Factoring in how your HP is related to your damage and your DPS in Isaac is very important to understand. And once you kind of grasp that idea that, hey, if I can protect this HP, then, you know, then the world is our oyster. And we can start looking at taking riskier plays, like taking the Satanic Bible, instead of us having to worry about being betrothed to only boss rooms that are giving us the possible advantage of getting a stat up. Now we're in a position where it's like, hey, we can take risks with our HP. No, we can do that. And we don't have to have boss room items saving us anymore. Satanic Bible will take that place. Got the credit card here in case we do find a good devil deal. I mean, if we get a devil deal on this floor, which is possible and likely. I don't know what hit me there. What did me? I guess it was the other eye. It just disappeared. Door. Oh, we can miss the 68% deal with the devil. That's fine, too. And Curse of the XL. Well, I have a cult kind of ruins tech one for us. Because now, even though it's homing, the problem is that now we can't turn directions in as fast as we would like to. I have a cult is essentially just marked, except it also has like homing. Now, of course, it's a lot different whenever you got tiers, because obviously you can change the direction of the tiers immediately when they're in the air and that sort of thing. But with tech one especially, it's not very good. So I would say that I have a cult in this case would definitely be a DPS down. I mean, you're seeing how even at close range, how difficult it is and how long it takes us to rotate the targeting reticule. I also think that was Bob's Curse in the item room, which is another big disappointment because, you know, Bob's Curse is just such a common drop. So there's lots of forces going up against us in this run. Crack the Skizzle was the other item in there, which we are probably not going to take. I could have used credit card on that devil on the Satanic Bible payout there and gotten both items. But again, with it being Curse of the Blind, I didn't want to get stuck with like Cursed Eye or something. Shot got a lot closer than I was expecting it to. That was Bob's Curse. Okay. So I have a feeling I hope our shop is over here, so we don't have to go look for it. Ooh. This looks like it's going to be an Isaac circle. Yep. Wow. Super secret rooms are eluding me today. Right, let's find that store because this is the last store that we're going to be able to get on this run. And we've got 63 cents, so hopefully we can get something for it. And with six bombs, I'm just going to start, motoring through here. That's seven bombs. Steel doesn't really do anything for us. And nuns have it. Hey, there we go. That wasn't too bad. Got two luck out of it. All right. So now the focus switches our faith into what the Satanic Bible can produce for us after bosses. Because again, remember we have more options. So it's a great synergy with more options as you know, in the Satanic Bible there. Tech 1 makes Mask of Infamy kind of a joke. Dark Bum. I'm very disappointed that we didn't get Spun either. But just think about how bad we'd be off right now without Tech 1 and without using Arky. Arky is the real story here for this run. This is definitely one of those episodes where the mosh pit. The part of the mosh pit that loves the slow crawls, the slogs of runs. Didn't get any sloggier than 52 minutes to the mom fight, although technically we did restart. And even then, it feels like a 22-minute mom fight. So the reason why I got the Polaroid the first time was because we wanted to take the negative the second time for the damage. And these are not phenomenal items, but I will use all the void for both of them. Oh yeah, I should have probably taken those. Yeah, right on down. So here we are. It's going to be Teratoma. Unfortunately, with Eye of a Cult, much like Marked, whenever you have Maw of the Void, it just fires on its own. So you can't really control when it goes off. I mean, of course, you can literally hit control and it will stop firing. But you know, you want to be dealing damage with your other shots as well. This really goes to show you how important having unlimited range is in keeping yourself safe here. My only debate is whether or not I want to use Zazel's Rage going off. Whether or not I want to use the Satanic Bible now, I have a cult really, really changes a lot of parts about this run. Not in a good way. I think Mom's Knife is about the only thing that we would want at this point from a double deal in terms of our tier effects. As far as like carry items are concerned. I mean, Brimstone would be fine too, but you know, we've all seen the consequences of a low damage Brimstone are far reaching. I think that Mom's Knife would scale a little bit better with the sitting at. Oh, that's fun. Sitting at 5.57 damage. Luck up's good. Luck up's fine. How's he pretty fly? Tears up as well. Man, I guess we can take the Crackjacks. And yeah, there we go. That's what I was hoping for. I didn't want to say it, but yeah. Curved Horn gets us a much needed damage upgrade. And Zazel's Wrath or Rage comes out right at the end here. I guess HP upgrade. We don't really need the Planetarium chance. Oh, okay. Sanguine Bond, why not? So definitely not the devil deals that we were looking for, or angel deals, really. We didn't get much. But you know, that's just sometimes that's just how the mob flops, you know. This run right here has been an exercise in patience. That's for Dagum, I'm sure. No, Isaac, thank you. Charge key, as we use it now. Zazel's Rage will spawn a Mega Troll Beam every 4 room clears, I think. Fortunately, the Mega Troll Beam doesn't really do increased amounts of damage like Mega would. Hermit card is going to allow us to teleport to somewhere random, which we can use in the chest. Secret room might be above here. But you see Isaac kind of like pulsating, glowing there. That means that the Azazel's Rage is charged and ready to go. So the next room that we go in that is unclear is going to proc Mega. Okay, we could get the virus here from Lust, and we did get spun. It only took us 2 freaking runs, but we did it. So we get spun. Let's not do that again, shall we, Bob's Curse? Thank you. All right, so spun gonna give us another nice damage upgrade here. And on the tail end of things have been picking up. Deck one again, even with Eye of a Cult here, should make Mom kind of a joke. See the activations there, Bighorn just going ham. Look at that. I'd even say Bighorn's going hand. Homing that we're getting from Eye of a Cult is definitely helping out a lot in certain situations. Again, I would prefer much just to not have Eye of a Cult. I really wish that it worked on Maul of the Void as well. That is kind of a bummer. Oh. From one boss to another. Okay, so let's read what Sanguinemon does, what the spikes do in Devil Rooms, because they do something completely different than the sacrifice spikes that you see in Angel Deals. So the Sanguine Bond taking damage from spikes has a chance to give rewards. 66 or 35% chance for 6 pennies, 15% chance for 0.5 damage up, Black Hearts 5% chance, random item 2% chance, Leviathan transformation 1% chance. And I think that's unlimited. So we're looking for the damage up or the Black Hearts or the random items for sure. We have enough hearts to go pretty hard on this. That gave us damage. That one didn't do anything. Fortunately, we have to wait for the pole or for the Virgo shield to wear off now, so this might be a little bit. Gave us more damage. Won't give us nothing. There's the coins. We're gonna use Satanic Bible just because we're getting charges off this anyway. Get more coins, okay. Nothing. Two soul hearts. Okay, we can keep on going. I'm gonna take this just to get it off the floor. Tired of trying to walk around it. Got more damage. That's great. Never really paid attention too much to Sanguine Bond other than, you know, basically this. Money here, which does nothing for us. Suboptimal with the with Virgo, obviously. I say suboptimal because we're sitting here having to wait for the shield to go off. Got the Leviathan transformation, which is a 1% chance and gives us flying. Wow. Now, there's no real question about how far we're going to go on this, on these spike rocks here, on the bond. Because we're getting damage and we have the Satanic Bible, so we can really get that HP that we're using back pretty quickly. If our damage keeps going up and up and up. I'm honestly kind of like shocked, but not shocked that we haven't gotten an item yet. But of course we get the 1% one that we weren't even trying for. Just does not want to give us an item at all. That's all I really wanted to see was that do we get a Devil Deal item or do we get just an item? There's no reason for us to just throw away the HP there. Our last life anyway. Look at the adult transformation here, which did give us an HP upgrade. But that Devil Deal with Sanguine Bond definitely paid out with a... I mean, that was huge. The amount of damage, but on top of that, we get flying. So maybe we shouldn't sleep on Sanguine Bond now. Although I was not really impressed that we didn't get an item. But a free Leviathan transformation is really, really powerful if you can get it. D-Fly. No, we stick with damage here. Thank you. go. Good time for Mega here. Pop off. Isaac now sitting at 50% and dropping fast. There we go. Look at that. Absolutely crushed Isaac. And we have finally made it to the chest. Mirko's veins. And for those of you who remember the No Seas run, the original one, you remember this room very well. Although we didn't get champion gurgling in this one, of course. Not the No Seas Repentance run, but the No Seas Afterbirth one. Good. So there is the west side of the map. I'm not going to take Cursed Eye. Although, I don't know how Cursed Eye interacts with Eye of the Occult. Does it just give you a straight up tears upgrade? Because we had the combo of Marked and Cursed Eye on the last run we did on stream, and it wasn't super. Yeah, that is significantly faster. So Cursed Eye makes it to, and it does the exact same thing as it does on Marked. So the closer you are to the targeting reticule with Cursed Eye, the faster you shoot. And that is basically tech 2 right there. I think Wooden Cross, maybe. Like upgrade. Nah, we'll stick with damage. We can take Lard. We're actually moving too fast, so it doesn't really matter. Didn't even affect our movement speed. So it's going to end up being a win. It was a very, very, very long-winded win, but we got there. And look at the damage come out here from Cursed Eye and Eye of the Occultist. Why not? If we die, we get teleported out of the door and we just go to the chest. I think we can do it, though. I don't think I've ever seen Satan start with that tear pattern. It's usually a brimstone shot. Keeping us close to the targeting reticule as possible is key here for our damage. Look how fast that was proccing. Oh my gosh. I take back what I said earlier. I don't think that Eye of Occult has actually degraded the effectiveness of Tech 1. I wasn't using it. I mean, we didn't have Cursed Eye. Cursed Eye is what's causing this to happen. That's what it did for Mark last night too. This whole range thing. At least I think that's what was happening with it. I'll sit there and trade with you. This is constant damage. I'm not moving. I don't care. Had the Virgo shield kick in a little bit later than I wanted it to. The reticule doesn't even have to be in our target. It just needs to be near Isaac. because of Eye of the Cult and giving us the homing tears. There you go. Down goes Mega Satan. Who would have thought that, huh? We don't have Polaroid. That's going to be torturous. I'm good with that. We got an extra boss done. We didn't think that we were going to get there, and we did. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. I hope you had a great start to your Sunday, and best of luck on your Isaac runs, everyone. And I hope you have a great start to your new week. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. As always, I will see you all next time. Also want to give a very special shout out to Lauren Montgomery, who has been in the mosh pit for quite some time, giving us the little rundowns as well as the Patreon shout outs as well. Extra special thank you to Lauren Montgomery for keeping that up for so long. I promise you, Lauren, it hasn't gone unnoticed. Thank you again very much for your contribution to the mosh pit. As always, I'll see you all again next time. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Nicholas Knight, AllWine13, Lysius Dex Ludix, Warren Hosinian, and Kelly McGuire. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.